Suppose you go to a shop and you purchase a bottle of Maza and you start drinking that Maza directly from a bottle. After some time you realize something is wrong with the bottle, and that's why you take a look at the bottle and you realize that there are some worms at the end of the bottle. Who is liable in this case? Whether the shopkeeper who stored Maza bottles or whether the manufacturer who manufactured Maza. Let us learn this through a very interesting case law in Law of Torts, and that is Donoghue versus Stevenson. Hey everyone, welcome to Law Simple and Pure. I'm your host Dr. Vaishali, and in today's lecture we are going to learn principle of negligence through a very important case law called Donoghue versus Stevenson. A long question can be asked, so if there is a question on negligence, you will cover this case law. If there is a short note, like write a case law or write a case study on Donoghue versus Stevenson, again same answer will be there. Or if there is a question, explain negligence with the help of case law, then again you will write the same case law. As I told you earlier, while teaching law of contract and while teaching so many case laws, that you are supposed to present your case law in a pattern. What is that pattern? Introduction to conclusion. So let us begin and let us cover each and every point in this case law. It is a very easy and interesting case law, so stay tuned. Introduction. In India, law of torts is not a codified law. Means there is no act of parliament or no statute. For example, on criminal law, we have Indian Penal Code. But for torts, we do not have any law statute. Okay, act of parliament is not there. Law of torts is based on British law of torts, okay, and British law of torts is based on judge-made law. So that's why these old British judgments are still followed in India. Some judgments are modified, some judgments are applied as it is. For example, Reliance versus Fletcher, principle of strict liability, was modified in MC Mehta versus Union of India in the form of absolute liability. So some case laws are applied with modification. Some case laws are still applied directly, and that's why we still refer these case laws, though they are old, because our law is based on British law and British law is based on case laws. Present case law in introduction, right, relates to principle of negligence, a very important topic in a subject law of torts. So this comes under negligence. What are the facts of this case? Well, Donoghue is a plaintiff. Okay, she is a Scottish widow. This is a Scottish case. So Donoghue is a widow, she is a plaintiff, and Mr. Stevenson is a defendant. So Donoghue filed a case against Stevenson, who is a defendant. So she is a widow and Mr. Stevenson is a beer manufacturer. So what happened? Donoghue and her friend, okay, they wanted to celebrate certain thing, and that's why they went to a local ice cream shop. They ordered ice cream and a bottle of ginger beer. Ginger beer came in an opaque bottle. Opaque means non-transparent. Okay, so bottle was non-transparent, so they couldn't see what is there in the bottle. So they started eating ice cream. They poured some beer on it and they started eating the ice cream. After some time, Donoghue poured remaining beer on the ice cream and a decomposed or a dead snail came floating out of the bottle. After seeing that, Donoghue and her friend, they felt sick. Okay, abdominal pain, nausea, such type of symptoms, and they went into a shock. Doctor told that they are suffering from gastrointestinal problems, okay, or gastrointestinal upset. So these are the facts of the case in short. And one important point, Donoghue's friend purchased beer from a shopkeeper. Okay, so Donoghue didn't directly purchase the beer bottle from a shopkeeper. So these are the facts of a case in short. Next is law points. What are the law points which were involved or discussed? Number one, whether there is any contract between Donoghue and Stevenson, because there is no contract, because Donoghue didn't purchase the beer bottle directly from a manufacturer, but her friend purchased it from a shopkeeper. So there is no contract between Donoghue and Stevenson. Number two, duty of care. Whether Mr. Stevenson has any duty of care towards Donoghue. So these two important points are involved. Matter went into House of Lords through the way of appeal. And Lord Atkins, he was there. He decided First, he invented neighborhood principle. In this case, it means you should love your neighbor. If you are making goods for a certain category of people, just like your neighbor, you are supposed to take care. Next, negligence is a tort. So Lord Atkins provided that, yes, there is no contract between Donoghue and Stevenson. So there is no direct contractual relationship. But this is negligence, and negligence is a part of torts. So case is maintainable. And next thing, duty of care. So Stevenson is a manufacturer and he has duty towards every consumer, whoever is consuming his product, whether he directly purchased it or indirectly consumed it. So duty of care is there. So these are the principle. Neighbor principle, you should love your neighbor, and just like your neighbor, you should take care of every person when you are dealing in that area and they are your customers. Second, negligence is a part of tort. So there, even if there is no privity of contract between Donoghue and Stevenson, still Mr. Stevenson is liable to pay Donoghue. And duty of final care. So every manufacturer has a duty of care towards his consumer. So this is a very important case. This is judgment of this case. One by one, explain everything beautifully and then conclude. Conclude that this case comes under the area of negligence. In case of negligence, provide. Okay, we will discuss it in a different topic again. So provide what negligence is about and why this case is important. This is still followed in India. So in this case, manufacturer is liable to consumer. So these are the facts. Conclude everything. And that's it. You will get full marks. So stay tuned till my next lecture, which will be on Reliance versus Fletcher, a next very important case law in Law of Torts. And students, please comment. I need your comments for my next lecture. Stay tuned. Till then, goodbye and good luck.